Hi there.
In this video, we'll be learning to create a resume in InDesign, so let's get started. I'm creating a letter-sized document, which is the apt size for a resume, and let me change the units to inches. The margins are already set to 0.25 inch, which is perfect, and let's add a bleed of 3 millimeters and hit create. First of all, let's drag the ruler and reset it at the top left bleed, and then drop a guide at 0.75 inch. Similarly, drag the ruler and reset it at the top right bleed and drop another guide at 0.75 inch from the right. Now I want to divide the space between the guides into three columns. So the way I'm going to do it is to pick the rectangle tool and make a rectangle stretching from the guide on the left to the guide on the right. And without releasing the mouse, hit the right arrow twice to split the rectangle into three. Now let's add a black fill to the stroke. To add a guide between the two rectangles, let's first group them so that we easily get the center point. Let's select the left and center rectangles and right click and select group. Now that we have the center point established, let's drop a guide at it. Let's now right click and ungroup them. Next, let's select the rectangle on the right and the center one, and then right click and group them. Drop a guide at the center point that you've just established, and then delete all three rectangles as we don't need them anymore. Let's grab the rectangle tool once again and make a rectangle in the first column touching the guides, and then place a guide at the center of this column with the help of the center handle of the rectangle. Let's double click the fill and change the color to orange. So let me pick this tone and hit OK. Since I don't want the rectangle to have sharp edges, let's round the corners from the toolbar above. Let me zoom in. And let's reduce the size of the rectangle from the sides, as we would want some padding on both sides, else it will look too tight between the columns. Let's pick the ellipse frame tool and holding Option and Shift on a Mac or Alt and Shift on a PC, click at the center guide, a little above the rectangle, and drag to make a circular frame. Let's go to File, and then Place, and locate the image on the computer, and hit Open. Let's pick the Type tool and make a text box for the name, and type in any name of your choice. I'm going to type in James Brown. Let's change the font to Humanist Bold and then center align it. Let's also increase the font size to 14 points. Now let's add the profession of this chap, and it's always better to just copy this text rather than creating a new text box altogether. So let's hold Option on a Mac or Alt on a PC and click and drag the text box down. Now type in Chemical Engineer as his profession. Let's change the font color to white, and lastly, update the font size to 8 points. Also, push it down a bit, and let's hit W for a preview. Before moving further, let's add a light background, as the boxes I'll be creating will have white backgrounds, so it's going to complement well. So let's hit the small plus button at the bottom of the layers panel to create a new layer. Now drag the new layer down and rename it background. Grab the rectangle tool and make a large rectangle covering the entire artboard, including the bleed. Now double click the fill option and pick a light color and hit OK. Let's check the preview. I think the background is complementing the orange color pretty well, so let's proceed with the rest of the text. Let's grab the type tool and make a text box right below the orange rectangle and type in my contact details. Select the text and using the eyedropper tool, steal the orange color from the rectangle. Also, change the font to Humanist Bold. I think we should up the size of the text a bit, so let's increase it to 12 points. Now copy this text box down and then drag to enlarge the text box. Here, I'm going to enter details like home phone number, mobile number, email address, LinkedIn address, and the physical address. You are at liberty to add other social media addresses as well. Once you've typed in all your contact details, select the entire text and reduce the font size to 10 points. Now select just the headings and change the font style to bold for all of them. I think I need to shorten the orange rectangle a bit. Now it's okay. Let's check the preview. And I think so far so good. Now let's grab the type tool and make a text box on the pasteboard, and then right click and fill it with placeholder text. We'll be borrowing text from here for the rest of the content. Now it's time to add some of our content to paragraph styles, since we'll be using them at multiple places. So let's select the orange heading and go to Window and then Styles and select Paragraph Styles. Now click the small plus button at the bottom of the Paragraph Styles panel to create a new style and rename it Heading Orange and hit OK. Next, drag a guide from the ruler above and drop it at the top of the orange rectangle. Now let's grab the rectangle tool and make a rectangle in the center column, touching the guides on either sides of the column. And then drop a guide at the center of this rectangle. And since we've established the center of the column, let's delete the rectangle. And then holding shift, click and drag the orange rectangle to this column, and it will be copied here. Let's change the color of this rectangle to white. Similarly, make a copy of the orange heading and place it here. Now change the heading to personal profile. At this point, we need another paragraph style for body text. So let's select the text on the left and click the small plus button at the bottom of the paragraph styles panel and double click and rename it body text and hit OK. Now let's grab the type tool and make a text box covering the rest of this white rectangle, leaving some padding space on all sides. Now copy some text from the text box we placed on the pasteboard earlier and then paste it here. With the text still selected, click the body text paragraph style and then make necessary paragraphing so that it looks presentable. Let's do some final adjustments to the text inside the white box. And once satisfied with the layout, hold Option and Shift on a Mac or Alt and Shift on a PC and copy this entire piece down. Next, drag the text box to make room for some more text. Update the heading to Educational Training. Then make another copy of the body text and place it below. Now select the text above and change its name to University of whatever. Change the font style to bold and then select this text and make another paragraph style and rename it Heading Black. Now make another copy of this heading and place it right below. Select the text and rename it Master in Chemical Engineering. Update the font style to italics. With the text still selected, create another paragraph style and rename it Heading Italics. Now move the text box closer to this heading and then select the text and go to the burger menu at the top right corner of the toolbar above and select bullets and numbering. From the list type option, select bullets and update the tab position to 0.2 inch and hit OK. Let's remove the space between the two bulleted sentences and ensure that your cursor is placed anywhere on the last line of the first bulleted sentence, and go to paragraph formatting controls and increase the space after to 0.125 inch. Let's also change the last bit of the first bulleted sentence to a year, like found in most of the complete degrees or diplomas. Now select these text boxes and holding Option and Shift on a Mac or Alt and Shift on a PC, drag them down to copy them. Now change the name of the university to whatever college. Also update the degree to Bachelor in Chemical Engineering. Lastly, update the year to 1995. Let's now move on to the last column and copy this entire piece and paste it here. Let's pick the rectangle tool and make a rectangle here, stretching from the guide on the left to the guide on the right to establish the center of this column, and then place a guide at the center, and then delete the rectangle. Now center align the whole box based on the guide we've just placed. Let's change the orange heading to career summary. Let's also change the black heading to whatever company. And the italics heading to lead engineer. Let's move on to the second company and rename it unknown company. And then the position to assistant engineer. Let's now make a copy of the personal profile box and paste it in the empty space here. Let's add another guide at the bottom of the two boxes to ensure their bottoms are aligned. Now change the orange heading to professional skills. Let's push this text box down and copy the black heading from the column on the left and paste it here. Align it and rename it whatever skills. Now push the text box up and delete the excess text. Now let's pick the line tool and make a line at the bottom and add black as the stroke color. Actually, let's change it to orange. So with the line still selected, pick the eyedropper tool and steal the orange color from the first rectangle we made. As you can see on the left, the orange is picked as the fill color and not the stroke color. So just press X and it will switch to the stroke color. Let's copy the orange heading and paste it here and rename it references. Similarly, copy a black heading and paste it here and rename it Mr. Jimmy Reese. Now place a guide at the left edge of the white rectangle on top. We're doing this to align the reference name to the rectangle above. Similarly, place a guide at the bottom of the headings at the bottom and align their bottoms if not aligned already. Now make another copy of the black heading and place it at the same line in the third column. Place a guide at the left edge of the white rectangle, much like we did earlier, and then align the name to this guide. Update the name to Mr. Tony Jacob. I just noticed that the professional skills box doesn't have the bullets. I think because we copied this box from the personal profile section and that did not have any bullets. So no worries. Let's select the text and go to the burger menu at the top right corner of the toolbar above and select bullets and numbering option. Change the list type to bullets and update the tab position to 0.2 inch and hit OK. Remove the line space between the two bulleted sentences and place the cursor anywhere on the last line of the first bulleted sentence. From the paragraph formatting controls option, go to the space after tab and increase the space to 0.125 inch. Lastly, grab the type tool and make a text box below the first reference name. Type in the position of the reference and then name of the company. Actually, let's push all of this a little above so that we have some space for another line here. Now let's add the cell phone number of Mr. Jimmy Reese. And select the text and click the body text paragraph style. Now select just the cell number and reduce the font size to 9 points. Now copy this text box and paste it to the right column for Mr. Tony Jacob. Perhaps we can change the position of Mr. Tony to project head in the unknown company. Let the phone number stay intact, who cares? And now is the right time to check the preview. Congratulations, guys. You've just learned how to create a CV in InDesign. All right, guys, that brings us to the close of the session, and I'm going to see you in the next one in just a bit. Goodbye.